Hello everyone, my name is Rem and I'd like to talk to you a little bit about membrane bass traps. The reason why I'm doing this video is because when I started working on my studio and treating it, there wasn't lots of information out there about it. And for me, there was some kind of a myth. I didn't know if they're gonna work before I started working on this project. And my good news to you is that they work. They work very well. In this video, we're gonna talk a little bit about the history, the formulas, then we're gonna talk how to actually build them. I'll show you some results and I hope it can help. So, not like pulse absorbers and broadband absorption, like foam and all types of fibers, the membrane bass trap is based on pressure. And what it can do, it can help you get to very low frequencies and treat them more efficiently. Because if you try to load more and more broadband absorption on a room, first of all, it will take lots of room. But second of all, you won't be able to get to those very low frequencies that are the fundamentals of the room. So this idea was first presented by the BBC in their researches. This is a paper from 1992 where they talked a little bit about Helmholtz and membrane bass traps and diaphragmatic traps. I'm gonna focus on this section on the membrane absorption, and they are showing us a little bit of formulas and the idea of how to do it, how it can help to treat a studio. The main idea of it is that there is a cavity, some kind of a cavity, and at the front of the cavity there is a membrane that is moving, and this membrane has a certain mass. The cavity has a depth, and this depth and the mass will determine what frequency this trap is treating. And this frequency is actually resonating in the cavity. Once you put in an absorbent material in the cavity, it will absorb this specific frequency. It's not a broadband trap. It is supposed to be tuned to a specific frequency or an area of frequencies that are really narrow. And in this way, you can treat frequencies that are low in terms of modes. So the mode of the, what are the mode of the room? I assume you all know the modes are the lower frequencies, the lowest frequencies that are resonating in the room. And those modes can be, it depends on the size of the room, but usually they will be very low. They will be in the 40 hertz range, 50 hertz range, etc. And it's very hard to treat it with broadband absorption. Especially today, when our studios are very small because, you know, real estate is expensive, and sometimes they are built of concrete, which enhance the effect of the modes, the resonating frequencies that we hear. If we didn't treat the modes, so we've put foam and we put other stuff on the walls, but the modes are still there. And they are apparent through the whole spectrum of frequencies. Their harmonic will be apparent as ringing in the upper frequencies. And if we really want to treat the room and we have the time and the knowledge and budget, we can do it. And one of the ways that I found is with those membrane traps. So before you actually building the traps, you need to know your room. And one of the ways to know the room is to measure the room and then use the formulas. But an easier way is to use this calculator, Amrock calculator. And you can put in, I've put here my studio. It's a small studio. It's almost like a cubic. And when you put it in the calculator, you see the modes. You see that the first mode is at 53.59 hertz and etc, etc. And in this video I'm gonna focus more about the first mode that you see right here, the fundamental frequency of around 53.5 or 53.59. You can see that we have another mode at the area of 55 hertz, 56 and 62-ish. So those are the fundamental frequencies that are resonating in the room. It can happen from the back and the front wall, the side walls, between the side walls and between the ceiling and the floor. And those are the frequencies that we'll want to address with the traps. In this video, I've focused more about the first mode, this one. And when I search the web, I'll give a little credit. So GearSlots, that is GearSpace today, Tim had a thread about his idea of limp mass bass absorbers. And he gives the ideas of how to put them together. And he also dealt with, of course, the formula. So let's talk a little bit about the formula. The basic formula that everyone are talking about is 600 divides by the root of M is the mass of the membrane. It's weight, kilograms per square meter. And D is the depth. So this is if we're talking in centimeters. If we're talking in inches, so it's 170 divides to those parameters. About the formulas that are, it's not something that you can rely on in 100%, because, for example, Art Noxon is also a specialist in acoustics for lots of years, and he suggests that because the cavity with the membrane and the fact that everything is air sealed, so he suggests that this is an isothermal cavity. The air inside is isothermal, and then we should change the number that we're dividing the mass and the depth, and we should decrease it and make it 84% than the original number. So if it was 170, it should be 143. And if it was 600, it should be 600 by 85% is 504, for example. I'll stop for a second about the formula, and then we're gonna get back through it. So how can we build it? First of all, we need a membrane, and the options are, the first option is MLV. So MLV is mass-loaded vinyl type of a roll. And you know, some people build membranes from a sheet of metal that they put inside an MLV, and then they close it together, a double-sided MLV, and they put a rubber roll, and they put the metal sheet in it. In my build, like, it's, I'm not saying that it is the best way to do it or the only way to do it. There's lots of ways to do it, but I'm showing you something that works and worked for me. And in my build, I've used a TechSound 50, which is some kind of a noise barrier, and it reminds of MLV, but it's a little bit different. And I found it to be in the right mess that I wanted, and it's easy to work with. So you can search it. It calls SoundTech 50. It comes with adhesive or without it, and you can use whatever you want. And another thing that you need is to decide what the cavity will be built from. Like those low frequencies, when they will push the membrane, they will try to rock the cavity. So it should be very heavy. And I've used MDF. And so we have the membrane, we have the cavity material. Of course, that everything will need to be air sealed. So no air to go inside or outside of the cavity. And we'll talk about it in a minute. Another thing that we need is, of course, the absorbent material. For this, I went with the Knauf. They have the Ecos glass mineral wool. They say that it's a little bit less itchy and it's more environmental friendly, but I've chosen it because it's really, really easy to design. And I thought it will be less itchy, but believe me, it is itchy. So be careful, put your protection on. So all those ingredients, we need to some kind think how we're going to put them together. I've talked about the formulas, and you saw that there's the basic formula, the isothermal formula. So I did my research, and at the end, the best thing for me that worked is this simulator, acousticmodeling.com. Because other than calculating the frequency, I can also know the strength of the absorption efficiency, and I can show you. So what we did and what you can do in order to do it, you go to acousticmodeling.com, you go to the layered traps, and then first we need the limp membrane. And then you need the mass of the membrane. So for the Tech Sound 50, it should be 5 kilograms per square meter. I've weighted it and I got to a result of, with mine, you need to calculate yours. And I got to a result of 4.925. What you can do is you can just take a small piece of it of 10 by 10 centimeters and then calculate it for a meter by meter. And okay, so in Tim's far end and it is built, he suggests, and I think that everyone else suggests, to put the absorption material at the back, right next to the back wall of the cavity. And when I started simulating this issue, I found that for me, it works better to put the fibers really closer to the, a lot closer to the membrane. So what I did, I left 3 centimeters clearance between the membrane and the fibers. And then I have put 10 centimeters of the wool of the Knauf Ecos. And then I've put 8.9 centimeters of air next to the back wall. I'll show you in a minute how it looks and how you build it exactly, but stay with me. And another parameter that is missing for you when you want to build this thing is the flow resistivity. Flow resistivity is Pascal per square meter. And there is lots of ignorance about this issue, and you will have a hard time trying to find what is the flow resistivity of your material. And even the companies that produce those things, they don't actually give you all this information really easily. So you have densities in those type of rolls, and you can get Ecos with 36 kilograms per square meter, 24 and 12. So from my research with Knauf, and I emailed with them and tried to understand better, my conclusions was that 36 kilograms rolls has a flow resistivity of 10K. So they have a 10K pascals per meter, per square meter, and the 24 has 7K, and the 12 has around 5K. If we'll go back to the simulator, so I also did another absorber over here for you guys to see what happens when you put the absorption in the back wall. So if I'm hitting calculate, you'll see the blue line, the blue Q, is absorber 1 when the absorption is closer to the membrane, and the green one is when the absorption is close to the back wall. As you can see, the absorption coefficient of absorber 1 is higher, like it's 100% absorbing the frequency of around 53 hertz. And when you look at the green, it absorbs lots less. In this desktop view of the website, I don't know why, but you don't see over here, there should be the info of the specific frequencies and the absorbing coefficient of it. And when you look at it on the mobile, it works. So I don't know why, but check on your mobile and you'll see this line. I've went with absorber 1. I advise you to do so if you like to build my model. So about the materials for the build, we've talked about the wood, we've talked about the membrane, we've talked about the absorption material, and as I said to you, it needs to be air sealed because all this thing is based on air pressure. So there's, when you build it, you need to think about it very well before you start to build, because it's very important. If it won't be air sealed, it won't work. So this is very important. And what I've used in order to make it better is Super 7 by HyberFix, which is both a glue and a sealer. Let's get to the build. And the build works this way. This is the frame as I did this absorber size of 120 by 60. And the total depth of it was 33, although I needed less, and I'll show you in a couple of minutes why. And the MDF, as you can see, is 2.8 centimeters. You can use whatever you want, it will still work. Then I chose to put a partition of like 10 centimeters depth, because it was just because it was a large absorber. You can do it with, you can do it without. What I did with the partition, I've put it at 3 centimeters shy from the membrane. Then you take the tech sound, you just cut it to the size you want. And when you take the tech sound, I advise you to just put the glue first. You will need a staple gun, of course, a staple handgun. And then put the staples, put the glue, and then let it stand. Let the absorber stand, and it will fall by itself after you've put lots of staples, of course, because the tech sound is heavy. And then add the glue all over the frame, and go nuts with the staples, because it should be very strong. Yep. The next thing that I did is, in order to put the absorber material really close to the membrane, and of course not touching it, because it shouldn't touch the membrane. If it will touch the membrane, nothing will work. I've chose to use some kind of a plastic net that you use for your garden. And then I've put it 3 centimeters shy from the membrane, and it's just touching the partition in my build. The way I did it, I've put screws all over the frame. I've connected the plastic net with the metal wire to the screws and stretched it, so it will be very strong and will not let the absorbent material touch the membrane. Before that, the cavity was sealed from the inside. So I've put the sealer next to the membrane and next to the wood. The next step will be to fill it with the earth wool, the Ecos Knauf earth wool. You just cut it to size. I needed to cut it twice because there was the partition, and you put it inside, it touches the net, it doesn't touches the membrane. And then you put the next plastic net. So the plastic net closes it in some kind of a cage in the middle of the cavity. Up next is the back wall. What I did in order to be more experimental, and you can do it also, because if you move to a different studio or you change, so you need to change the frequency, you can actually adjust the back wall, and based on a calculation, and it can help. It was sealed also because you want it to be airtight. Some results. So if we're looking at 53.2 hertz, which is around the frequency that I aimed to, you can see that from 174 dBs, it went down to 162 dBs. And the null was over here at 44. It was also minimized, because that what happens when you deal with those peaks of modes. Most of the times, the cancellation before and after it will get better. A waterfall view, as you see, this crazy mountain was the area of 53 hertz. After, it looks like this. So of course, in this waterfall, I needed to treat also the 55 hertz range, but it wasn't applied yet. So even if I just treated the 53 area with this absorber, I did two of them. This is after two absorber in the room, in the corners. So it looks like this. About the position, you can try what works best for you. I've found that the corners are best for me. So you can see there is a huge change in the waterfall, in the decay time of the mode, of the frequencies mode. You can also see an RT20. Over here you can see that you have decay time of 1.9 seconds at around 50 hertz. And after the two absorbers, you see something that's around 650 milliseconds at the same area. And you can see also the effect on the area of 60 hertz, which got a lot better. spectrogram is another way to look at it. You can see the 50 hertz area was really hot over here, and this is after. So as you see, they work, and they work very well. It's all a matter of how you put them together and where you place them and how you calculate things. Final tip to you, if you like to make it nicer and you don't want to see the ugly TechSound membrane, you can create a frame from wood that doesn't touch the membrane and just upholstery it with a nice fabric on it. Just make sure you don't touch the membrane. And if you like to see how it looks, in my case, after everything was set with different types of membranes to all of the modes of this specific studio. So this is the frequency response before all the membranes, and this is after, of course, with other acoustic treatment, but still you can see how it worked. And if you like to see a waterfall view, so this is before with all the hills and valleys, and this is after.